asked me today in the gym. It's a reality.
Yeah.
It's a reality. And like Chris said, from Chris's background, I come from a boxing background, and when I was fighting, I never even wanted to sit next to a guy that smoked a cigarette. And now when I'm getting ready for a show, although since the early 90s, I have toned myself down because I am getting older, and I don't want to, you know, literally pass away or end up on a machine at a certain age. Because don't be fooled. Don't be fooled. When you're putting artificial stuff in your body, you are drastically changing the course of events in the history of your health. You don't know what you could be opening up. So I tell guys, especially young guys, dude, unless you're going to make a living at it, unless you feel that you can be a true champion, unless you're really willing to take a risk, don't do it. Don't do it because of these freaking gym doctors that are out there. These Johnny blowbags I see every day with the blown up faces and you know, I'm taking 10 Anadrol and I'm doing this. Those guys are jokes. They end up staying in the gyms for the rest of their lives and not doing anything. It's a very drastic step that you'll have to take. And again, like I think everybody up here, I myself, when it comes time to get ready for a show, I have some real moral issues with it. I hate doing it. I hate doing anything like it. But in order to be, and they don't make you a champion. Don't be fooled either. They don't make you a champion. Extremely, I know all these guys up here, especially Flex, Chris, Kevin. I've trained with these guys since the early 90s. I've competed against them. These guys are major league intense trainers. And when they get hooked on something, like a show, they're getting ready for a show, it's balls to the wall. So all the other stuff is secondary. But you guys don't feel bad about asking those questions because it's so much out there. It's perpetuated everywhere now.
But please don't allow that to limit you in asking any